Welcome to NetSet OS. Today we will see conversion of decimal to binary using recursion. But before this, we should know how to do it mathematically. So let's take an example, let's say 9. And make sure whatever remainder we'll be having, we will write besides this cell. That means in this cell. And quotient will be here below the 9. As binary is always represented by 0 and 1. That means two numbers. So we will take 2 over here. Now here 9 is there. So I need to divide by 2. So 2 fours are 8. And 1 will be our remainder. So 1 will come here besides it. And 4 will be a quotient. So I'll write below this 9 cell. Again I'll repeat the process for 2. And I have to repeat this process till it becomes 0. So here when I divide 4 by 2, I'll get 2 twos are 4. 0 will be our remainder and 2 will be our quotient. So here I'll write 2 quotient and 0 will be our remainder. Then again, I'll repeat this process for 2 twos are. For 2 ones are 2. 0 will be our remainder. So I'll put here and 1 is our quotient. Now again I'll repeat the process for 1. When I have 2 and this 1, that means I'll divide 1 by 2. Here 2 zeros are 0. That means 1 will be our remainder and remainder will be here and 0 will be our quotient. Now we got our 0. That means this remainder in the form of bottom to top will be taken as binary form of 9. Now let's see how to represent it by programming. Now here I have made a new file with name recursive underscore binary as I have to convert decimal number to binary. So for this, I'll start with making function with def find. And here I need to give my decimal number. So I'll write this num. And then before starting a program, we should have one thing in our mind. If we are making program on recursion, there should be a base condition first. So here I'll make it with if this number, that means that decimal number is equal to 0, it will return. Else, it will take the number as find decimal number and will divide this number by 2. And then it will print its remainder. And remainder is always this number modulus 2. And here decimal by 2 should be in integer. So I'll write here int and we'll put parenthesis here. Now I need to call this. So I'll just write find decimal number. And for this, I'll write, let's say 9 only. And here when I run this, I'm getting all the number 1001, but they are in different lines. So here I'll write comma and is equal to apostrophe. Now when I print this, I'll get all the binary number in the same line. Now let's understand how this recursion actually works. So I'll just remove this. Now here I have taken decimal number as 9 for F 9. Now we have two statements over here. 1 and 2. If we have 9 is equal to 0, it will return to the last. Otherwise, it will go to else condition. Now here, 9 is not equal to 0, then we will go to else part. And here we have two statements. That means there will be a tree. So here, first is 9 divided by 2. That means 9 divided by 2 is 4 and it should be an int. So here, it will come to F. The second statement is print its modulus 2. That means when we divide 9 by 2, we'll be having 4 as quotient and 1 as remainder. So here it will come 1 as our remainder and it will get printed. Similarly, we will go for F4 as it is a tree representation. We will go downwards. Now here F4, is 4 is equal to 0? No. So it will come to else part. And here also we will have two branches of this F4. Here 4 is divided by 2. When 4 is divided by 2, we will get 2. And 2 is dividing 4, so 2 twos are 4. And we will get 0 as a remainder. It is asking for printing remainder of this. So here it will print 0. Then again, we will go to F2. Is 2 is equal to 0? No. So it will come to else part and we will have two branches over here. It will ask for 2 divided by 2. We will have 0 as our remainder and 1 our quotient. So here I'll write fine 1 and here when print remainder, which will be print 0. Then again it will go to F1. It will ask 1 is equal to 0? No. So it will go to else part. That means it again it will have two branches. It will go to 1 divided by 2. That means 2 zeros are 0 and 1 will be a remainder. So here it is asking for F. This quotient will come here and printing its remainder. So here we will write 1. Now again it will go whether 0 is equal to 0. Yes, it is 0. So it will return without printing anything. Now here it will go to F1. So for this, I'll rub this. So it will print 1. Then again it will go to F2. Here it is saying print 0. So it will print 0. Then again it will go to F4, which is asking for printing 0. It will print 0. Then again it will go to F9 and it will ask to print 1. So this is how decimal to binary work recursively. And here I'm coming out with Python series where you can find each concept over here with real world examples. So you can follow this and each day I'm coming with a new concept and by following step by step, you can come up to advanced level. So for this, start following my videos and get subscribed to it.
Thanks for watching.
Drop a like.
Leave a comment.
And don't forget to
subscribe.